resilience, in simple terms, could mean fighting to the finish, not giving up. It was a not-so-clear October Sunday morning as I walked up on that red carpeted stage in my frilly blue dress I had secretly dreaded wearing the day before. I could already feel it, the nausea of it all, the nervousness coursing through my veins like I was about to fall off a cliff, the blood rushing through my body like it had just tripled its speed, all the 500 eyes watching, waiting for me, my next step, my next note. My hands tensed as I positioned the guitar on my torso and began strumming the first chord of the song. This was the part where I started singing, so where was my voice? For a split second, I thought I couldn't find it, but after what seemed like the longest 5 seconds of my life, here it was, singing in uniform speed with the guitar I was now strumming. After about 3 minutes of not the best singing, I came to an end to await judgment, the worst part. The part where I run away from the thoughts and the opinions of the audience and the judges. Only I didn't do that. I couldn't do that because for some reason my legs were planted firmly buckled on that stage underneath me. Here in this teen church, favoritism came with familiarity, something I barely had with this audience and the judges as well. I can't remember walking off that stage, but I found myself in my seat as the crowd gave a mediocre cheer for me, just like they did any other contestant they didn't know. It will be another tense week before I knew if I advanced to the next round, and ignoring that thought seemed like an emotional challenge I could not win. So I let myself build false hopes for the Sunday I couldn't wait for and dreaded at the same time. The day finally came, and I can't remember being ready, but I had to face it. After a long hour of contemplating hopes and thoughts and guesses, I was finally called upstage, and then it happened again. The part where I get so tense, I can barely hear what anyone is saying. But from the expression of my friend's face, I already knew the verdict from the judges, how my lack of stage presence had overruled my performance and I was disqualified. Although all the false hopes I had built within that past week had turned to disappointment and sadness. I had learned from past efforts not to let this sadness grow, because the more it grew, the harder it was for it to be replaced with happiness. And while part of me did that, part of me tried to fight it. Part of me tried to fight the battle within me, where I could tell myself I was just this 12-year-old who couldn't do more than what little she had done, or I could come back and I could improve. I could get over this temporary failure and come back stronger and stronger. So my decision was made. The only thing I could do to prove this to myself was to come back next year, and the year after next year, and the year after next year, for this same teens competition, until I won. I'm not here to tell you a typical don't give up, do better next time story. My point is you can give up. But just because you give up doesn't mean everyone else will. Don't let simple failures, little failures that can get over, define you and your limitations. Someone else might fail just as bad as you did and decide to come back stronger while you stay behind and miss out on the recognition you could have gotten, the recognition you deserve. So my audience, listener, or potential friend, resilience plays out in different circumstances or ways in our lives. And while failing doesn't mean failing forever, failing and giving up, failing and procrastinating, stalling on when to move on, can all leave long-term effects on your emotional states. And although I did say favoritism sometimes comes with familiarity, I hope you can ponder on my message and understand the true meaning of resilience. Thank you.